is sent by email to the Asbury Park Press and the Co-Star, our official newspapers, and posted on the bulletin board of the municipal building.
Thank you. Good evening and welcome to the July 18, 2022 meeting of the Planning Board of Belmar. Please join the board in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Kimball, please, roll call.
Mr. Meyer?
Here.
Mr. Ramena?
Present.
Mr. Colianis?
Here.
Mr. McDermott?
Here.
Mr. Lindsay?
Here.
Mr. Pavani?
Here.
Mr. Fierro?
Here.
Mr. Forte? And Mr. De Blasio and Ms. West are absent.
Okay, thank you. Doug, I do not believe we have anything in our workshop discussion this evening, correct?
Only if you want to have me quickly review the application of the recording.
If you would do that, please, and then we'll jump into the approval of the minutes.
I think the one application is going to carry, the human application is going to carry. The next application that you have is Down to Earth Construction. This is a subdivision. It's often difficult for the board of subdivisions. You're not seeing a site plan. Not seeing a full plan for a finished approved site, but this is simply where the applicant is coming on the old, I guess it's the emergency. The first aid. The first aid building property. This is over, it's on the corner of 9th and D Street. The applicant is proposing to take that one large lot of approximately 22,000 plus or minus feet and divide it into, subdivide it into three lots. That's a minor subdivision. In order to do that, and in order to be allowed to do that, you're going to have to grant the applicant certain variance relief. In this instance, the variance relief. There's going to be frontage. There's going to be a frontage variance for the corner lot, because as you know, on a corner lot, and that's going to be, I think, 10.01, you really have two front yards. Let me deal with the frontage. On the corner lot, it's a little bit oversized lot. The frontage should be 60 feet. They're only going to propose 50 feet for that. The lot area for that particular corner lot is also supposed to be 9,000 square feet. They are proposing 7,366.29 square feet. What I was getting to before is on a corner lot, you have two front yard setbacks, if you will. You've got the front yard that's along 9th, which appears in this instance is not going to require variance relief, but with regard to the front yard or side yard or front yard setback along B Street, where they would normally have to have about 20 feet, they're only going to propose 10.20 feet. So what you're going to have is you look down the block, depending on whether or not there's other conforming lots or not, you're going to have a little bit of a jut out at that corner piece. North or south, depending on how you go along there. And I hope they'll provide some testimony as to what the general setback is. I think there are some concerns that our engineer has mentioned that there may be one non-conforming lot that juts out a little bit as to whether or not you consider that as part of your average setback. Realize usually what you're doing is you're looking to your adjoining lots as to what your average setbacks is. And if you recall, as you go along this particular property, D goes into South Lake, so you have kind of a cut. So you kind of jump into the next block, but there's sufficient space back there. So I think what the applicant is doing is looking at the next block further, I guess it's south in this instance, to talk about what the average setback should be. The other difficulty that you have with regard to simply having a subdivision is what the applicant has done, and they're certainly permitted to do this. This is not to be taken as a negative comment in any shape or form. But without the site plan, it's simply the subdivision, you don't see the layout of potentially curb cuts. Are there going to be accessory garage structures? There is a notation for accessory garage structures. they're not on your subdivision map at this point in time. They appear that they can build them conforming. There is no layout of a attached accessory garage. We may want to have the applicant provide some testimony. As I say, it's not a site plan, but if you're looking at already minimum side yards between the properties as you head further east, you've got 5 yard, 5 yard, 5 yard, 5 yard. Also, isn't there, and this may have been a variance that was missed, is the combined supposed to be 15?
I'm not aware of that.
Okay, Michelle.
We have that in our letter. They said for proposed lot 10.02 and 10.03, the combined side yard setback would be greater than 15 feet. And because proposed lot 10.01 is a corner lot, there is no combined side yard setback.
Okay, thank you very much. So you don't really see those full layouts. There's at least a notation as to on block, I guess it's block 93, block further south, where they talk about porches jutting into the setback, if you will. I don't know whether the applicants are proposing to have porches. If they are, again, without the site plan, you may want to at least have to provide some testimony as to if they are going to develop the porches. Are they going to be porches at front of the 9th Avenue? Or are they going to be porches potentially coming even further into the side yard setback, front yard or side yard setback along D Street? As I say, we don't know where the curb cuts would be. We may want to have some discussions. There is a notation that there are no wetlands in this area. We're going to have some discussion as to how service is going to be provided to these lots. Will it be provided separate service on each lot? Will the applicant also propose a utilities plan? They have asked for certain waivers in addition to the variances for lot area, frontage, setback. They've asked for certain waivers by way of waivers from the environmental impact statement. They have not submitted that to you in this instance. We want to hear some testimony as to why they think they should not be submitting that and whether or not our engineer believes that's appropriate. There's also no stormwater management report placed in. There's no traffic plan or traffic study. There's also no landscaping plan proposed. I think at least you'd like to have some idea of what the applicant is going to do again. They're not obliged by way of a site plan, but you want to make sure that if you're going to have a landscaping, if suddenly for some reason someone is going to put other than green grass along the area, that we'd like to know that. Again, the absence of a stormwater management plan, we'd like to know where stormwater is going sometimes. We want to make sure that we're able to contain the site drains to the site without requiring rain gardens, without requiring something else along those lines. The engineer has submitted their report and their review. Should have an opportunity to examine that, where they've highlighted some additional testimonies that they think would be appropriate to hear from. And hear the applicant touch on that. We've already touched on the corner lot, the area, the frontage, front yard setback. As conditions of approval, our engineer is recommending that when we get there, if we get there, we want to approve it, that conditions of approval should include that the applicant removes all structures before the subdivision is perfected, so that you don't have a situation where the building is still in existence there, and the subdivision, they want to perfect the subdivision. You'd like to be able to do that. You'd like to usually have landmarks or markers placed or where the subdivision lot lines are going to be proposed. If the applicant is proposed to perfect the subdivision by deed, the deed should be reviewed by, approved by the borough engineer and the borough attorney prior to filing, always payment of real estate taxes, and also abandonment of the construction permit. So they are here just for, as I say, subdivision relief, but we can also get into a little bit of that testimony as to how they see it being developed down the line. Give you some idea what the impact is going to be like, obviously. Something like driveways and curb cuts will impact how the site is developed, you know, how the applicant is proposing to do that. So the variances that I've identified and also approval as to the waivers attached. That's your application, it's one lot into three.
Thank you, Doug.
Yep.
All right, moving on the agenda. Can I have a motion to waive the reading and approve the minutes from our June 1st, 2022 meeting?
Oh, okay.
Thank you, Rick. Can I get a second?
Second.
Thank you, Ted.
Mr. Meyer?
Yes.
Mr. Almeida?
Stand.
Mr. Pompenzis?
Yes.
Mr. McDermott?
Yes.
Mr. Lindsay?
Yes.
Mr. Carmelli?
Yes.
Mr. Fiero?
Stand.
Mr. Forte?
Yes.
Thank you. All right, as noted by Doug, the applications this evening, the first, that of Randall Marvin Newman, that's been continued. I'm sorry? Oh, sorry.
Here's the chief.
Can I have a motion to waive the reading and approve the resolution approving the application of Hazel Boutique at 1202 Main Street? Ted? I'm sorry.
No, me.
No, Tom, sorry.
Sorry.
Thanks, Ted.
Mr. Meyer?
Tom?
Yes.
Mr. Almeida?
Stand.
Mr. Pompenzis?
Yes.
Mr. McDermott?
Yes.
Mr. Lindsay?
Yes.
Mr. Carmelli?
Yes.
Mr. Fiero?
Yes.
Mr. Forte?
Yes.
Now, one continued, that of Randall and Marvin Newman. That will be carried to our August 15th meeting, is that confirmed?
Correct.
Okay. So this evening, we have one application, as Doug summarized in our workshop, that of Down to Earth Construction LLC at 414 Ninth Avenue.
Take over just for a few moments.
Please.
We have jurisdiction on this, we have a few looking green cards. The applicant's witnesses, just to stand for a second.
Before we do that, Mr. Chairman, with respect to Mr. Gomez, as I answered this evening, I was approached by a gentleman who is an adjacent landowner. There's another adjacent landowner there. I think there should be some discussion between my client and those two fellows before we proceed, so I think it will create a fork in the road as to which way I proceed in the matter. I don't like to waste anyone's time. I don't want to come back. If possible, I want to try to deal with issues as I learn them and see them, as opposed to trying to work them out 3 hours down the road when you say, why don't you fuck it up again?
So 15-minute adjournment will work?
Yeah, I think it should.
Okay.
And if not, I'll report back.
All right. So we'll take a 15-minute adjournment.
Don't talk amongst yourselves. We're technically adjourned. I will take roll call again.
Yes.
Mr. Meyer?
Here.
Mr. Almeida?
Present.
Mr. Pompenzis?
Here.
Mr. McDermott?
Yes.
Mr. Lindsay?
Here.
Mr. Carmelli?
Here.
Mr. Fiero?
Here.
Mr. Forte?
Here.
My floor?
Yes, if you'd like, Mr. Sharpers. Go ahead.
Thank you, Mr. Gomez. Mr. Chairman and board members, for the record, William Schaefer, Sammy Schaefer, Zelensky, Belmar, East Brunswick, on behalf of the applicant, Down to Earth Construction. To my right, Bill Merkler.
So what's your last name?
Bill Monka is the project engineer. Wolf Bossian's back here. Why don't we swear them, Mr. Gomez, just for the purpose of the discussion this evening?
And we do have to mark the exhibit yet, so.
Yeah, there's a procedural issue we want to talk about.
Okay.
May say something if during this portion, please stand. Raise your right hand. It's only swear the testimony. I'm about to give the truth, the whole truth, not the truth.
Yes, it is.
Okay.
So board members, I'm certain that you've looked at the engineering review letter, you've looked at RC Associates' plan before you, some brief recidivist history as to what's going on here. There's a gentleman, it's O'Connor, right? Not Connor? Is it O'Connor?
I'm O'Connor.
O'Connor. And to his right is?
Carlene.
Mr. Carlene. Those two gentlemen back there are the owners of respective lots 9 and 8 on the top of the plan. So the history is effectively this, and I didn't necessarily litigate it, but I have a pretty strong understanding. The gentleman behind me, if there's any need for any further clarification, I think will also clarify if the time comes. But in in any event, the subject of this subdivision is the Belmar First Aid Building that I think we're all familiar with on B Street and 9th. It was suspected to be 150 by 150 feet when Mr. Merkler, Down to Earth Construction, contracted with the Belmar First Aid to buy the building as the highest successful bidder to his firm. As that process was occurring, Mr. O'Connor retained counsel and litigated what we call an adverse possession claim, alleging that he had maintained and possessed for the statutory period or his predecessor's entitled the area that you see in the side hatch at the back, or the back of our lots, or the top of our plan, if you all see that. And the cross hatch transverses the boundary of lot 9, lot 83, and our lot at issue. The court granted adverse possession in favor of Mr. O'Connor, and he was represented, where the rescue squad, or first aid squad, was represented by the Pringle Quinn Ganzano firm. They filed an appeal to the appellate division of the trial court, Judge Bauman, in Freehold's grant of adverse possession. The closing ultimately took place. Down to Earth purchased the property with all rights reserved coming to them of the ambulance property, and they would have the ability to either choose to prosecute the appeal through the appellate division and contest the adverse possession finding, or they can do whatever. And I think the intention back then with the Pringle firm, because I was not involved candidly with the plot plan before you, was that they were going to come before the board and see this current three-lot subdivision as per drawn by RC Associates. Once Mr. Merkler took title, he adopted their plan, and this is the plan that he presents, the plan that the Pringle firm had formulated with their professionals. All well and good, and we noticed appropriately, based upon the zoning grid and the zoning chart prepared by RC Associates, and Mr. Carleen, through counsel, via a letter dated July 15th, who did not participate in the prior litigation, did not acquire a victory for adverse possession, nor was he subject to a defeat, which either could have happened depending on circumstance. He was not in that necessary fight. His counsel and he believe that they do have claim of right for a portion, if not all, of the balance of the non-hatched property on the current site plan. And that would be the boundary between lot 8 and the current site at issue. You'll see there's like a 2.7 lineage of a chain number. So with that, we came here tonight to put Mr. Merkler and the two gentlemen together to decide what their all respective positions were. The parties, and I'll speak, and in the event the other two gentlemen behind me want to correct or add anything, all three of the gentlemen basically agreed, let's live harmoniously. I believe they support the three-lot subdivision. And their position is that let's move this forward, although Mr. Carleen has an agreement with Mr. Merkler that if approved, Mr. Merkler would probably quit claim the remaining strip to him, and everyone would essentially live harmoniously. Mr. Merkler's homes would be built pursuant to lots that were 147 feet deep instead of 150 feet deep, and hopefully discuss the matter. Ms. Kovacs, I believe, has a particular position perhaps regarding, I don't want to put words in his mouth, perhaps notice and the numbers and percent, the percentages were not supplied. The lot area was supplied. We're trying to figure out a way. You're all here. My clients are here. The professionals here. And most importantly, and I thank their appearance, Ms. Parley and Mr. O'Connor are here. And they seem to support the application. I want to try to get this done this evening. In the event that we can move forward, it is the desire of Mr. Merkler and BPE Construction to move forward. And at this juncture, I will yield the floor to Mr. Kovacs for his discussion with the board. I say for the record that he was kind enough with the borough engineer and planner to meet with me during our timeout period so that I could alert them to what has transpired since I received the letter this morning. So we're all on the same page, no surprises. And most importantly, not to go through a 2-hour presentation and the board members say, what if or what about, or I have an issue with this, or I don't have an issue, or it could affect my vote. Wanted to flush it here first. Thank you.
Would you like to go to executive session? We can ask the people to step out for a moment. We can do that here.
Please. Can I have a motion to go to executive session?
Motion to go into executive session for the purpose of discussing the applicant's issue this evening with regard to the potential legal impact that may have from the board receiving counsel from me.
There's a motion from Mr. Lindsay,
right? Yes, and second by Tom.
All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
15 minutes, Mr. Chairman?
It's a little near 50. We step out. We have a private attorney client discussion with. Basically, I've had an opportunity to speak with my client, Mr. Shapers, members of the public. Thank you for giving us that little extra time. It is my counsel to the board that when you finally resolve your issues with regard to that back piece along lot 8, lot 83, and once you know what the entire impact of that's going to be on the lot size of 10.03, that you do a revised notice for the square footage. I'm imagining, based upon representations made before, it's probably not going to impact too much else, but I think it's going to hold up how we proceed potentially without their proper notice, and I don't need to have that extra legal issue down the line if someone challenges the notice. I understand that this is always something that is time sensitive, but I think once you've wrapped that up and you know exactly what that square footage is going to be, that would be the best, and have your notice done so that people don't have any complaints if they didn't really know what that lot size was. I would ask that you take a brief adjournment, waive your time limits, and proceed from there.
I think I'm going to look to the chairman. Mr. Chairman will abide your desire.
In terms of what was just stated?
Yeah.
Yeah, that we've spoken through that as a board, and we feel like given the technical issues with the notice and concerns with that, we want to wait until it's resolved.
And there's not much reason for me to talk with my client. Thank you. We will waive time in which the decision must be made. Thank you.
Thank you.
Are wasted of our lives.
Would you like to make a comment? Please step forward, state your name, spell it, write your street address.
This is in reference to the applications up front. Bruce Blatt, 407 9th Avenue. within 200 feet of the proposed demolition reconstruction. Member of the First Aid Squad for 2 years, and I'm hoping that the board approves this request. I think it's only an asset to this, to our neighborhood. I'm, like I said, 200 feet within the area, right across the street from the First Aid Squad. That's why I bought my house, because I've been on the squad for all those years. But I know the work that Bill, his company has done, excellent work, and I just, speaking in favor of the application for everything.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you for your patience as well.
Thank you very much.
Anyone else from the public? Seeing no one, I'll close the public portion. That was the last item on the agenda.
If I could just add one thing. I was just checking the calendar. I know we had sent the Newman application maybe August 15th, but our meeting in August, we actually approved and scheduled it for the 22nd.
Okay.
I'll clarify that.
I represent that application and would have no objection. I think the additional time would be appreciated by that.
Yeah, actually, that's when our meeting is scheduled in August, too, so that works out well.
That's 7 o'clock.
7 o'clock, right. All right. Anything else, April?
No, that's it.
Mark, Mr. Chairman, are we,
because your lot size. Oh, I'm sorry, which meeting was that?
The Newman meeting, not that. We know where we are.
Has there been any changes? I think you're going to have to renotice with my record. Well, I don't know what you're doing that may or may not be different in regard to the Newman application.
I thought we were waiting for this so we could see the application at the next meeting. Now with 2 meetings.
Because our people haven't had anything to review at this point. And if we were going to, again, I'm concerned if there's any dramatic changes to the application. I don't know that at this point.
I don't think we would rise to the level of dramatic. I think there were desires.
Coming back to your question on notice, I don't know if you have notes on that though, but I think you probably going to have to renotice, especially if it moves out again, it moves beyond the logs.
Okay. I'll advise that you have to renotice of the
property. I think since it went 2 meetings, I think we owe the public the same notice.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right. Seeing nothing else, can I get a motion to close this evening's meeting? Ted, second?
Second.
Bill, thank you.
All in favor?
Aye.